They say fear haunts you, and pain hates. I say pain strengthens, and fear drives faith. And I don't know. Hey, what's up, everybody? I appreciate you guys tuning in. It is Tuesday, and it's story time. You have John. John is a guy that decided to do something different with his life. He decided to leave his simple town and join the military. He joined the military because he got married, has two kids, and he decided that this would be a good career path for him, that he can go, he can serve his country, and he can make some money, and he can provide for his family. So in the process of John going to the military, he spent about 5-6 years in the military, and he went to go overseas. While being overseas, he became a sergeant, and he became, you know, he had his platoon that he was over. So John's doing pretty good for himself. You know, different ranks, he's moving on up. He's gaining respect from people. He's going throughout this unknown area, and he's talking to people, and he's getting to know the civilians in this area, and he's talking with them, and he's building relationships. He's building relationships with his platoon. He knows their family. He's encouraging them. He's uplifting them. He's becoming a great leader, somebody that they can look up to. John is that guy. John is that guy that they trust to make the right decisions if need be. John is that guy where he has all the power to make that right decision if need be. So just a normal night, John is in his platoon are awakened by bombs, and they realize that they're under attack. So John has to make some decisions, you know, tell people where to go. You go here, you go there, you go here. John finds himself in a situation where he has to make a choice. It's either him or his platoon. And during his training, he was told about these type of situations where you'll have to make those decisions where it's going to be you or your people. And it's going to be you doing the right thing for your country. So John's in that position. John is in that position to decide who he wants to put on the front line. And John's thinking about all those people. He's thinking about those people's family. He's thinking about the wife, the kids, and stuff like that. He's not thinking about himself. John makes the decision. He makes the decision to go front, and he decides to put himself on the front line and his man behind him. John takes it all. John ends up losing his life. Now, we all know how the situation goes, so news gets back to the States. It gets back to his wife, his family. Everybody's mourning, and they're sad to hear the news of John, but he's a hero to this country. This guy decided to take a stand, put himself on the front line. So for his country, even though he knew the consequences, but he knew his calling was to be in this position, and that eventually one day he would have to make that choice and that decision. And rightfully so, front page paper, you know, Nobel Peace Prize, all these things. And it's not just John. We think about civil rights people, Martin Luther King, Harriet Tubman. We think about all these people that have put themselves on the front line of fire. They were the point man in their situation for the betterment of other people, even though people wouldn't appreciate it. Now rewind 2,000 plus years back, and no matter how many times we hear stories of John, Martin Luther King, it does something to our heart. My challenge to you guys today is, my question to you guys is that when we think about 2,000 years ago when Christ did the same thing, why doesn't that story have the same effect on us? Christ was called to this earth to serve one purpose, and that purpose was to die a gruesome death, and he did that. In the same life that we live, the same temptations that we have, and he was flawless, he was perfect. And even though he knew that people would not appreciate him and what he was doing for us to give us the opportunity to have grace and mercy and forgiveness, even though he knew people wouldn't appreciate that, even though John knew that it would be people that wouldn't like this country and do things they shouldn't do, even though he's on the front line giving us freedom, even though Martin Luther King did what he done, even though it would be people that wouldn't appreciate what these people stood for, the movements that they have, they chose to do it. Those stories mean something. My challenge to you guys is today, don't let Christ's story not mean nothing, because it means everything. It means so much to us, and we take it for granted, the sacrifice that Christ made for us. That's all I got for you guys today. I appreciate you guys tuning in. I'm out.
fears crawling through the windows, waiting for them to attack. They say don't get bitter, get better. I'm working on switching them letters. But tell God I'ma need a whole lot of hope keeping it together. I'm smiling in everyone's face. I'm crying whenever they leave the room. They don't know the battle I face. They don't understand.